What's up, everybody? How's it going today? How's it going? Something... Well, welcome back? Hello, everyone! Welcome back! Oh, jeez. I can't believe we are playing Tales of Berseria again. What are the odds, right? I mean, it's not like this has been going on for a couple or more months now or anything like that. No, of course not. This is the first time I've ever played this game. In like about five, well, ever, forever, you know, five ever. Woo! That's what I wanted to say. Wow, jeez. What is the shape of this room that we're about to enter? It seems like it's got an odd sun shape to it? I don't know, it kind of looks like it has a sun shape to it for some reason. Could it be Majora's Mask? It has a Majora's Mask shape to it. I don't know why, it just kind of has a weird mask-like shape to it. So for some reason, I just decided to say Majora's Mask, because why not? I don't know. Dang, they're hiding treasure chests here. They just had to be doing that. What happens if I miss these? If I miss these, I might not ever come back here again. Probably. I mean, I don't know. I guess it's possible. But I feel, while that could be a possibility, I feel like it's also unlikely. I mean, what are the odds of me coming back here? This is just an odd location. Like, come on now. I don't expect to come back here. I certainly don't expect you to expect me to come back here. I mean, I press the LT button, they won't even let me put up the bottle for possible usages. So if I can't even use bottles here, then, well, yeah, probably can't come back here. That's probably not going to happen. I think you can count on that. I mean, give me the warp point, thank you very much. How big is this place, seriously? I thought we were almost at the end of this place, but apparently not. I was lied to. Or not. Maybe not. Aizen?
Is this?
Never mind.
Look! Hey, stay with me. I'll get someone right away.
It's okay. I'm tired.
Have you been journeying long, then?
10 years. My master entrusted everything to me. But I couldn't do anything.
10 years?
My wings are weak. It doesn't matter anymore.
I see. If you've been working that hard, you surely need a break. I just happened to get my hands on some prickle boar meat. I'll be cooking up a stew for dinner. But would you care to join me?
Huh? No, I...
All I have on me now is this apple. Here. Once your belly is full of warm food, you'll be able to pick yourself back up. I can feel it. Your body is shouting, I want to live.
I'm a disgrace. I don't deserve to live.
Is life something you have to earn? To deserve?
Well...
These feelings are natural. You eat when you're hungry and cry when you're sad. Feeling these things is proof that we're alive.
Alive?
What's your name? Mine is Celica. Celica Crow.
I'm an exorcist. Artorius. No, Arthur. I'm Arthur.
Artorius!
Calm down, Velvet. Jeez.
What in the world was that?
Rokuro! Aizen!
You saw it too, then?
Sure did. Artorius. And he called himself Arthur. I've heard of this. The Earthen Historia.
I was going to say that, Aizen! Gosh dang it! I swear. At the end of this cutscene, I was going to be like, that's the Earth. That was like an Earthen Historia, wasn't it? Freaking Aizen, you beat me to the punch. I knew it. I was going to say it, and then he just had to go and say it first. Darn it, Aizen. You know, you just... You gotta do things. Alright, just go on with your speech, man.
Events on the world's surface cast imprints on the earth pulse that runs below.
In other words, an illusion of the past.
It's not an illusion. That was my sister. So, you managed to fool her too, is it? Yes. Yes, that must be it. That's why she freed me from the prison.
Rokuro, have you recovered from your wounds?
Yep. Tough as nails, that's old Rokuro. I'm more worried about Velvet. She okay?
How could she be okay? Inominat is reborn, and it's her little brother.
A blade can't just be hard. It's gotta be flexible, or it'll snap the first time it meets an unexpected force. I misunderstood the true meaning of strength, and so did he.
Let's just worry about ourselves for now. This Earth Pulse is completely under Inominat's domain. We can think of it as an extension of his body.
Yeah, which means my power won't get us out of here.
Be wary. Inominat may be the one showing us these memories. Remember, he's after Velvet.
And the two types of malevolence inside her.
True. And we may be able to use that against him to get us out of here.
What are you saying? Just use her?
If it's necessary.
We have to keep moving. Nothing will be gained by staying here. And we ought to look for Magilu. Even she doesn't deserve to be stuck here forever.
Well, you don't need to worry about that. She's not actually stuck here, but hey, you know.
Take a look at
that's just Magilu for you. She finds a way to just have things happen somehow. Alright, go back there. I should not have done that, actually. You know what? I can cancel it. I'm gonna cancel it real quick. Go back to Albane, dang it.
Scout ship set.
We need to. Just need to. Alright, so let's see. We're gonna go over there.
If I'm in this. I'm in this
100%. Good. Good to know. Good to know, man. So let's see. We go with that order. Wait, no. Rokuro, you were number two, weren't you? I think that was what it was. If I remember correctly, anyway. So that is our main party. The only one missing is just someone who's not in our main party, so... Big whoop, right? Yep. No. We gotta do this as Aizen here. It's gotta be done as Aizen. Didn't really want to fight, but I wasn't really given a choice. So, you know what? Time for some snakes, everyone. Time for some snakes. Ah, jeez. I'm burning. I'm on fire. Stop, drop, and roll, Aizen! I don't want to stop, drop, and roll. I'm pressing the stop, drop, and roll button. Oh well, he's out of flames anyway. It went out on its own. Somehow he managed to put it
another
out.
Another victory.
Aizen, how'd you do that? Are you a wizard? I swear, you must be a wizard. Okie dokie. I swear, Aizen. Just had to beat me to the punch. It's like you have this secret competition with not just Rokuro, but also me too. It's like, come on. I'm trying to be the first one to say something here. And you're like, no, I'm going to say it first. And now you're probably all thinking like, oh sure, Kratos, you're totally going to say... that was the Earth and
so
Historia.
So, what is this Earth and Historia you mentioned?
As I've said, an Earth Pulse is a natural force that circulates within the land. Wind blows, water flows, birds fly, flowers bloom. All actions in nature leave their mark on the Earth Pulse. These marks become etched within the land itself and remain a part of the Earth Pulse, like memories.
So it's a record of the world's past.
Does it remember human and Moloch deeds?
Everything that occurs is part of nature, including the acts of humans, Molochim, and even demons.
So that means that even this very conversation is being recorded in the Earth and Historia?
Anything bad I've done in secret, any insults you've ever told behind someone's back, the land sees it all.
My insults?
It's just an example. Pay it no mind.
Does that mean that Inominat is drawing specific memories from the Earth and Historia and showing them to Velvet?
I believe so. That's how Rokuro and I saw the same thing, even though we weren't there. With the Earth itself as his vessel, it's a trick only Inominat could pull off.
Awfully devious for a self-styled Empyrean.
But the attack did strike home. Keep a close watch on her until we're out of the Earth Pulse.
Right.
And what's keeping close watch really gonna do? I mean, it's just gonna... I have no idea, honestly. On the brink of destruction!
Velvet's psyche took a heavy blow there.
Yes. She's in rough shape.
How long do you think she'll last?
What do you mean?
Just what I said. Remember, hardness alone won't save you from breaking. If she keeps being shaken up like this, she won't be able to handle it.
But what can we do?
If she breaks, she breaks. Until then, we go on with our mission.
What? Can't we help her?
If you let sympathy fog your vision, you can end up crashed on a reef.
Even so, we can't just let her suffer. It's too much.
I'm fairly sure that Velvet would say the same thing if she was in Aizen's place.
And do you agree, Rokuro?
Me? I still have a debt to Velvet. I will pay it. But in the end, her fate will be something she'll have to decide for herself.
That's true, but...
Then I have a decision of my own to make. I won't give up on Velvet, no matter what.
I see. Do what you have to.
We won't stop you.
Eh, you could always try to stop him. I don't know. So... Oh, okay. Magilu's the one who's cooking right now, huh? And she's not in the party, obviously, so, whatever, you know, just... Maybe I should change out the cooking for a little bit here. Let's see now. Who's gonna cook? It is going to be, let's just make it Aizen. He does do defense after all.
Try some.
This'll do. I'll try some, man. Yes. You got this. Make sure you do it right. Or else. I don't know. Where was I going with that? Let's that. No, I'm just kidding. I was about to say something completely different right there. Let's rock. Yeah, that's probably what you thought I was gonna say, didn't you? Oh, no. But actually, yes, but, you know, no. Just no. Get me out of here. Warp me somewhere new. Oh, this is not somewhere new. It's still the same place. You know, I hate how they just keep saying, well, this is a new area, but it really isn't. We're lying to you. Oh, wait a second now. This could go so many different directions. Not really. Because now I know that this one leads to a dead end. Or at least it looked like it led to a dead end. That's where I want to go. I want to go to dead ends, so that way I can get treasure chests. Why did I say it like that? I don't know. Probably because I'm tired. I just want to get those treasure chests, though. And I want to say it weird, too. Because that's how you say things. How do you say things, everyone? Do you say... things? I don't know. Something like that. You say things by saying things. Oh, jeez. Wow, that's kind of crazy. That's mind-blowing. I never knew that. Whoa. There's got to be something hiding here. I knew it. How did I know that? So anyway, I guess... Well, that episode's come out now, obviously. That episode where that game crashed on me. I guess now I know if that ever happens again in the future. Well, the recording's still going to be running, apparently, so... That's nice to know, and didn't have to be like, wow, that's crazy. So in the future, when that happens again, I can just be like, well, you know, the game crashed on me, big whoop. But I can still end an episode if it happens at the end of an episode. So that'll be nice, I guess. Oh, geez, get away from me, I don't want to fight you. If you understand that fighting is not the answer sometimes. Jeez. Freaking demons, I swear.
Welcome home, Arthur.
Hi, Celica. I fixed the fence around the house.
Oh, thank you, sweetheart. With the brigands stepping up their attacks, the town elders have been worried. But this should put their minds at ease.
No. If the brigands turn into demons, a mere fence won't stop them.
Hmm?
Nothing. Don't worry about it. I'm pretty confident in my carpentry. And the other two?
Probably at the Cape again. I've warned them 100 times that it's dangerous.
Luffy said probably badgered Velvet into going. Don't worry, she'll watch out for him.
Yeah, I can only hope that this little one grows up to be as strong as she is one day.
Huh?
You're happy, I hope.
Of course I am. I never thought I could ever be this happy. I only wish I'd known earlier. I would have made something even nicer for you.
Oh, you made this for me?
Yeah. I put all my heart into it.
I'll cherish it always. It'll remind me of this happy day.
Let this serve as proof of our love. This I swear. I swear to protect you both with my life.
Velvet, I said calm down, jeez!
That's Lord Artorius's past.
Oh, that's rich! You mean you believe that tripe?
It's all a pack of lies. His smile, his promise, everything.
How do you figure that? Oh my gosh, we're being watched by the Lord of all demons! Wait a second. I thought we already had Lord
to
of all demons.
I ate up his lies. Without questioning a word. What a joke.
Velvet, seriously, just like, calm down. Just a little bit here. Come on now. A vision of the past is a vision of the past. You can't deny a vision of the past.
What we just saw. Was that from before the opening?
Yeah. Celica was there. And Artorius still had use of his arm. It didn't look like he was an exorcist either.
I never would have thought Lord Artorius could smile so tenderly.
But he's since become an exorcist, taking on the mantle of shepherd and the weight of the world.
All because he lost his beloved wife.
I'd understand if you wanted to back out. But at this rate, I think the time is coming. Not much longer now.
It's coming.
Didn't he say before in the first little thing? Or, well, whatever. When Celica and Artorius both met, didn't he say that I'm an exorcist named Artorius? And then he stopped himself and said, I'm Arthur. He said he was an exorcist, so he already was an exorcist. What the heck are you talking about, Lafayette? And I'm like, oh, this is before he became an exorcist. Like, what? Are you serious? Was no one paying attention to the previous thing that happened? I feel like I was paying attention. Or was I? Maybe I was the one who wasn't paying attention. No, but seriously, come on. That's wrong. That is just so wrong now. Is that a thing that I can go across by any chance? It is not. It does not appear to be the case. Though these crystals do disappear, I mean, oh my gosh, I can't run! Wow, what the heck? That doesn't make it. Oh, I see. It's blocking me off. No, I'm just kidding. But seriously, though. I don't know. I feel like objects like that just shouldn't disappear like that. It should be a solid wall. Therefore, the camera should have, like, some detection with it, but no, it doesn't. There's reasons. We're not allowed to detect crystals like that. We're gonna make them disappear for no reason, because that's better. So much better that way. How could it not be? I'm really getting tired of this place. I want to get out of here. This place is just so blue. I mean, it looks nice, but at some point, it's just like, get me out of here. Get me out of here! Ah! Oh no! Lloyd, what are we gonna do? Oh, get me out of here! Ah! No, I'm just kidding.
Didn't know those things about Artorius and Celica, did she?
I'm losing my
Probably
mind.
Probably not. That was when the two were alone and first getting to know each other.
We were seeing glimpses of a warm, loving family. But really, it just gave me the creeps.
Same here. I could keenly feel Enominat scheming behind everything we saw.
He's trying to get at Velvet.
I think she used to truly love Lord Artorius.
Having that happy past thrust in front of her at a time like this must be tearing her apart.
Probably, but a demon like me wouldn't understand.
What Velvet is going through is horrible. Even as a human, I can scarcely imagine what it must be like. But I approach it, just a little bit, because like her, I was his pupil.
Artorius said he needed two types of malevolence to awaken an Ominat. The illusions at a ball, making sure we knew about the attack on Titania, and Inominat appearing as her brother. If all of that was planned to extract the malevolence from her, we'd all better brace for worse to come.
It'll be fine. I don't think we need to worry about it. Or do we? What do we do? I don't know. Get away from me! I know you're too fast for me! So therefore, I'm just gonna run away from you, because I'm too slow. Gosh dang it, no, you are... Well, you're really slow, actually, so I really don't need to worry about you. Here's one more treasure chest, and I want to find it. More than Historia! Maybe. Or could be a monster.
The Scarlet Knight? This is Velvet's village.
Damn! So many of them! Celica, I'm coming!
It's too late! Take Velvet and Lafayette and run!
I can't do that! I want to have my life with you! With our child! Why? Why couldn't I? Why couldn't I protect my own family?
Remember this moment well, Artorius. Humans are weak, filled with sin.
Melchior.
The people of this village offered you and your beloved family up to the demon brigands. A sacrifice, so that they could escape and hide.
No, they wouldn't.
It happens often. The reason people act on is burdened by the weight of their sins. However... I have found a method to adjust their reason.
A domain? What is this incredible power? Don't tell me the Imperium we've been searching for was here this whole time. Molochin.
So they have been reborn, but be not deceived. They are not the same people you knew.
Why? Why must fate be so cruel?
It appears that Inominat's resurrection is incomplete. We must guide him until we understand why. I'll be taking these Malakim.
Wait! sorry I couldn't keep my promise. I'll make things right. I'll abandon who I am. Nameless Moloch, I will forge a pact with you. I will put an end to all the pain in this world.
Do you have it in you? You who abandoned my friend's ideals and fled.
On the souls of my dead master, wife, and child, this I swear. My name is Artorius Colbrand. I have inherited the will and the strength of Claudin Asgard, former head of the Exorcists.
Very well. Let tonight's tragedy change fate and birth salvation.
Moloch, it was me. You don't remember?
Not at all.
They said you were reborn as a Moloch. That means... what exactly?
The soul of a human who passed away can, given the right trigger, be reborn as a Moloch.
You're saying that Artorius's child was reborn as Lafayette?
If what we saw was real, yes.
So the female Moloch that was born along with him was...
my sister's reincarnation. But I ate her long ago.
You didn't know, right?
I knew. I had already caught on to who Ceres really was.
Velvet...
but it doesn't matter. What does it change? I'll devour anything to fulfill my goal. My sister, my brother, even the world. That's who I am. That's all I am.
Okay, so I'm gonna just say, I'll admit that I think it was pretty obvious that Ceres was, well, Celica, because, well, I mean, I won't say, like, what Velvet said was what made it obvious, because, I mean, obviously, that made it obvious, but I think there was a certain point where I kind of was thinking maybe, oh, okay, maybe this is a possibility. I don't really know, but I'm kind of just thinking this maybe. I think one of you also, well, one of you who haven't played this game before, I think you were also thinking that that was a possibility, and, you know, you were right. You were definitely right on your... yes, I was actually kind of agreeing with you that that was a possibility, and that's right. It definitely is right. I don't want to go too far because I want to get the skit, but I want to also say what I want to say, but... the thing that really surprises me, though, is the whole Lafayette thing now. Or the Moloch Lafayette, I should say. That is a little surprising now that was the unborn child of Artorius and Celica. That is... that's actually really interesting now. At least I think so. My goodness, what the heck? Who would have guessed that would have been the thing? Now, did you expect that? Now, that's a kind of a twist, if you ask me, anyway. I was like, whoa. At least in my head, I was like, whoa, because I didn't want to be like, well, out loud. Whoa! What the heck? And then make it all like, well, that doesn't make any sense. Well, why would you be shouting at the top of your lungs at this point in the game? I don't really know, because I feel like it. But I didn't want to right there. I was just a little surprised nonetheless, though. I'm going to have to fight this thing anyway. That sucks. Oh, well. The day the shepherd was born.
That was the day all of this started, wasn't it?
Yeah, the opening. Innominat was halfway revived and demons became visible to all.
His power also robbed almost every Moloch of their free will that day.
I never imagined that Lord Artorius's quest to change the world was so steeped in tragedy. The villagers should have never sold them out to those bandits.
It was cruel, yes, but nothing remarkable. People are capable of anything when under pressure, even more so when they can do it under the mantle of the greater good.
Velvet's family was probably the furthest outside the village circle that night.
That's pure selfishness.
Humans are selfish creatures. You should be aware of that by now. That's why you said what you said just now, even if you didn't know it. Artorius's quest to change the world, not Artorius's quest to save humanity.
I
mean no disrespect. It's just an observation.
A man with the power to change the world turned his back on the potential of humanity. That may be the biggest tragedy of that night.
The savior of the world lost all hope in its people.
It happens. Sometimes it just happens. And it kind of sucks, but what can you really do about it, I suppose? What was I looking at? I swear there was something I was going to look at, but I don't remember now. Oh, I got boots. So that's for sure. Oh my gosh. Wow, boots. It's amazing. Do I have anything mastered? No. I swear there's something I was going to look at, but I don't remember. Cooking, no. Arts, no. Okay, I don't know. But either way, I suppose I should just... Yay! Get a dangerous encounter! Yeah! Woo! Oh my gosh, everyone. This is quite the amazing feat that we just accomplished today. Dangerous encounters and everything. Yeah, you better believe it. They're all gonna die. It's gonna be so easy. And they're gonna be like, wow! Oh my gosh, you killed me! And then it's gonna be like, wow, I didn't really need you. No! I should have done another move. I should have showed them my moves and I completely forgot about it. What a shame. I tried. Burn! I'm gonna get you! You've been gotten! Woo! You did it. I told you. How many times do I have to tell you that you actually did it? Not too many, I suppose. Or maybe just enough to actually make a real difference. Oh, I didn't get the kill.
I unleashed all my power. Maybe
what
I
a shame.
It.
I'm the one who unleashed all my power, and yet Rokuro's the one who's bragging about it. What the heck? That doesn't even make any sense. Oh well. I don't care. I'm gonna just go ahead and master another piece of equipment, which is only this quartz bracelet. But hey, equipment skills, learning speed. Tell me I had this the whole time and I didn't realize it? Oh my gosh, I'm stupid. Well, whatever. I'm gonna go ahead and... Wait a second now. I could go over here. You're telling me I could actually go over here and get a treasure chest? What the heck? How can I possibly get a treasure chest over here? I might be going insane. Again. Well, whatever. I don't really know. Am I going insane? Yes, of course I am. But regardless if I'm going insane or not, I think on the next episode, we're going to be going to the next location. Will it finally be the end of this place? Will we finally be the end of this place or not? I would really like to see the end of this place, I'm just saying. All the cutscenes are really interesting, but I want to see the end of this place. I want to see a new environment again. Or at least an older environment that isn't this place. I don't know. Gosh dang it. So now we know the true meaning of Ceres and Lafiset. Moloch Lafiset, I should say. We know how they came to be, who they once were. Theory is proven correct. What is the meaning of this? I don't really know.